ones just going around living their dull lives, living in dull houses, and they're not being themselves. Well, I don't know, perhaps they are, perhaps most people are generally dull and boring. But, you know, you look out the window and you see these row upon row of houses, and they all look the same, and the people come out in the mornings and they all look the same, and they all go to work and they all sit there behind their desks and their offices that all look the same. There's no, you don't seem to get any individuality at all really everyday life. It's just dead. I like people that are gonna express themselves, do what they want.
Working in department stores and shops, the girls have always sort of thought me a bit unusual, and then they start laughing at me, and also being gay I have to keep it quiet, and I get a lot of pressure there, and they sort of, then they start sort of criticising me, and they just treat me as a joke in the end, and I just go very quiet at work, I just can't come.
About 4 in the morning, 4 in the morning, I never go to bed before 3. Because there's no point. I never want to get up. The only time I get up is if it's sunny, I want to go to suntan. That's the only reason.
Some people, the younger ones, can't get jobs because it's really difficult for school leavers, but some of the older ones, I think it's because they are very individual type of personalities. They can't fit into the 9-to-5 routine. They find it very difficult to do that. And they're constantly looking around for a job that they really want to do. A job they can express their personalities in, but of course it's very hard to find, and they tend to drift on and not bother getting a job. I know several people like that.
Working at a shop in Kensington, and I was just doing all the clients that nobody else wanted to do. Although I'd only done 2 years training, I was like doing all the colour work that nobody else could be bothered to do and things like that. And I just thought, well, what's the point? And they were really using me as well, because it was a new sort of trendy shop, and they'd have lots of photographers in, and like they'd sort of send me up the stairs to be nice to the photographers and things. And I just thought, well, I'm just being used as a puppet for this place. So I thought, I'll branch out and do something else.
It's a definite rejection of the way society has forced you to be. It's a matter of saying, I will not do what you tell me. I may do it for 7 hours a day, so that you cannot control me. It's not just a rejection, it's a statement against, a protest against the fact that society is so rigid that anyone who's slightly different, be it in mind or thinking, is immediately sort of labelled and boxed and filed away and tried to put away somewhere. You get stopped by the police and you don't get served in pubs and you are ostracised by everyone. And after a while, that just the being ostracised by everyone is addictive. You enjoy it, you revel in it, because it means that society is so scared of you that they do not wish you to have you in their company, which shows how narrow-minded most people are, the fact that they cannot cope with anything slightly different, in the same way that a mother will try and reject a baby that is born disabled. They don't want it. They don't want to say that's come from us. So they try and lock it away and stick it in a home.
Mm.
And what you're doing is bringing it onto the streets and saying, look, bad luck, you can't stop me. You can hit me over the head with a bottle, but you can't stop me, and I'm allowed to go where I want to. So it's a definite poke in the side, needling pain in Joe Public's little cosy world.
Everyday David Bowie that no one sees, you know. The one that goes to the laundrette and goes down for the tea bags and things, but also
a very
specific, I'm female, so if I get taken for a guy, or even in the very extreme cases, very occasionally I have been taken for David Bowie, but you know, sort of sprinkled around over the last 6 years, it's certainly a desire not to be anonymous, but in a very extreme way, because I've taken a very specific Bowie character, which was probably the most extreme character, and that was the Man Who Fell to Earth.
It comes from inside you, and not from sort of things happening around you. I mean, you just turn a blind eye to it now. I mean, I walk down the street and don't see anyone. I mean, you don't notice people looking at you or staring, screaming at you, because you just walk around with your head in the ground. Because you get so bored with it all. You know, people. People are very narrow-minded.
I've become so used to people's attitudes of being mixing with like gay people all the time, and then all being with people like Scarlett, and just all the people that are completely open-minded. You forget all about the narrow-minded people that really exist, and that's the whole thing that I've got into. You just forget about that whole straight world.
I can't say I feel freer myself for liking the horror. I just love the effect it has on people. When I go out with all my grey and white makeup on, I do it very skull-like, and I love it. And people generally, I mean, especially girls, they hate it, because you're not supposed to do makeup like that. You're supposed to use makeup to enhance yourself. But why? I mean, I like going out looking like a skull. I love skulls. So I love sort of having very deep set eyes and grey face and grey skin, looking like death warmed up. I mean, that appeals to me. It's part of me, therefore I'm going to do it.
Well, I like wearing makeup because it's... Well, I like the hour or so before getting ready and putting it on, and like an artist draws a picture, I like to paint my face. You know, it's, I like to see how different I can look with makeup on. I mean, some days I put it on and it's really awful, but I like it, so I wear it. Other days I like to take an hour, 2 hours, really being prissy and getting all the nice little details and really transforming myself into something else.
I think it's a type of escapism again,
yeah.
You know, especially from ordinary jobs, or even if they're on the dole doing nothing during the day, and then they look forward to going out to a club and dressing up, and it's just a whole different world. You find a lot of people on the dole really look good. I mean, they've bought their clothes for next to nothing, but they put them together in an individual way, and you'd never imagine they were on the dole. They look really good.
Everything
like sort of like bright things don't really come into our lives. Like, we're all into different aspects of black. There's definitely the sexual and sort of gothic horror side of black, which we all like. But there's also the sort of I suppose sleazy side is the same sort of thing, really. But it's night time when we come in from work and you've been sitting around in the daylight all day, and the night's just sort of a cover. We are very night people, really. We have to go out and put up with everyone during the day. But black just is us. You can use it as a cover, you can use it as whatever you want. It's, people have always been afraid of the dark. And I think people have always been afraid of the dark because it's representative of everything taboo. Like everything taboo always goes on in the dark, or in dark rooms, or behind closed doors. And I prefer that side of life to sort of the everyday routine, one of the meals, sit at a desk type thing. I feel more myself. I mean, during the day you've got, everything's artificial. You know, everyone's just going around living their lives how everyone expects them to be. And during the night, sort of a different side of you comes out. You can be yourself. You can use the night as a cloak. You know, you can sort of hide away in corners or use it as just a background, which is what we do basically. With everything being so black around us. And the night's sort of our ideal time. It must be great being a vampire.
I was like a total night person. I used to sleep. In the winter I just sleep all day, warm up all night. And in the winter I never see daylight. In the summer I never see night time. Because I go to work about 9 o'clock when it's, you know, still light. Mm. By the time I leave it's, you know, 4 o'clock morning, it's sunny again. It's really weird. There's so many people that live like that though, who surprise, go to clubs every night. They must work in the evening, early evening. They just sleep all day.
In a way, that's part of the enjoyment of the night sometimes. Because if it wasn't necessary, I don't know, there's something about going out at night and you get all dressed up, you get all keyed up, and it's actually going there, and that's often the best bit. It's when you get there that you find you're sitting down on the table, listening to loud music you don't want to, with overcrowded, there's people.
You can dress differently at night time. You can be more, you're not so exposed as you are in the daytime because you haven't got the light. It's the thing of electric light. It's much more flattering, it's much more mysterious, and it's just more fun being out at night. And daytime, I just feel everyone looks really ugly and like really bad skin and tired, and night time they don't. It's like being in a movie at night time, isn't it? Think about it. Whereas, because it's all artificial lighting, whereas in the daytime it's reality.